Most of us like the additional alternative that Airbnb offers for holidays. Tourists can stay at much cheaper places and in better locations compared to expensive hotels, and residents can earn a few extra bucks when they have a spare apartment or even just a spare room. Today, whenever we do a city trip or even a longer holiday on the beach, we routinely check Airbnb to see if we can snatch a great offer. But just like many other companies, the story of Airbnb is not one without setbacks. In hindsight, we might think that Airbnb was such a great business that, if we were working for a VC fund, we would definitely invest into them. But in reality, Airbnb had an incredibly hard time raising money to build their company. So hard, in fact, that they would have had to end the company before it really began, had they not come up with a great idea to fund themselves. As promised, we continue our series about companies that managed to achieve a crazy turnaround story. After our last video about Apple, the story of Airbnb is our second video. Keep watching to find out about the hurdles that this young company had to overcome. Also, please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button so that you can see future videos. We will keep educating you about the richest people and the interesting stories that the world of business has to offer. Today's company that managed to turn around gracefully is Airbnb. Shortly after moving to San Francisco in October 2007, roommates and former schoolmates Brian Chesky and Joe Gebbia came up with the idea of putting an air mattress in their living room and turning it into a bed and breakfast, in order to offset the high costs of renting an apartment in San Francisco. In 2008, Nathan Bleshartzik, Chesky's former roommate, joined as the chief technology officer and the third co-founder of the new venture, which they initially named Air Bed and Breakfast. They put together a website that offered short-term living quarters, and the website officially launched on the 11th of August in 2008. Problem was, they had no investors and thousands of dollars of combined credit card debt, so the founders had to figure out how to keep the company afloat to prevent an early bankruptcy. They came up with an incredibly simple idea: selling custom-made cereal boxes. The founders managed to make a whopping $30,000 within 2 months selling the Obama O's and Captain McCain's. They also came up with some pretty funny jingles. Still, the founders described this time as their lowest point, since they had to live off of cereal boxes to keep Airbnb alive. Following this small success that resulted in the survival of their company, the founders were invited to a training session of a startup incubator called Y Combinator, which provided them with training as well as $20,000 in funding. Still, the founders were only making $200 a week and decided to ask users about their experience. They discovered that the main problem was that the pictures of most listings weren't of high quality, so they decided to rent a professional camera and went door to door to take better pictures of as many listings as possible in New York. This approach led to 2 or 3 times as many bookings on New York listings, and by the end of the month, Airbnb's revenue in the city had doubled. After visiting their users to take pictures, the company had finally gained some traction. Airbnb was finally able to grow exponentially, and by March 2009, the website had 10,000 users and 2,500 listings. Also that year, the company managed to secure about $600,000 of seed money from Sequoia Capital, and in 2010, they even managed to raise about $7.2 million from Greylock Partners and, again, from Sequoia Capital. In July 2011, Airbnb managed to raise an impressive $112 million in a financing round led by Andreessen Horowitz, one of the most famous venture capital investing firms in the world. In June 2012, Airbnb announced its 10 millionth night booked, doubling business in the previous 5 months. Subsequently, more and more financing was secured, which meant that Airbnb was finally sitting firmly in the saddle. By this time, Airbnb had raised a total of $3 billion, and it reached a valuation of $31 billion. In April 2012, Airbnb raised another $1 billion from Silver Lake and Sixth Street Partners. Besides receiving enormous amounts of funding, Airbnb also acquired other companies. It acquired international competitors, online city guides, location-based Q&A platforms, social payment startups, and online marketplaces. Airbnb first became profitable during the second half of 2016, 9 years after its founding. Airbnb's revenue grew by more than 80% from 2015 to 2016, and after a profit of $200 million in 2018, Airbnb posted a loss of $322 million in 2009. 2019. This is even though by October 2019, 2 million people were staying with Airbnb each single night. Due to COVID-19, Airbnb suffered a significant drop in bookings, which lowered its internal valuation from $31 billion to $26 billion US dollars. As a result, the company announced the layoff of around 1,900 employees. On the 19th of August in this year, Airbnb announced that they had filed for an initial public offering. It took us 12 years to build Airbnb, and we lost almost everything in 4 to 6 weeks, Chesky said in an interview with CNBC. He also added, "Tourism as we knew it is over." It will be interesting to see how Airbnb manages to maneuver out of the current crisis. We hope that their IPO will be a success and that they will be able to do business again very soon. The founders surely want to cash in and sell some of their shares at the IPO. If they do so, they will become billionaires for sure. Some of you might not have known that Airbnb was struggling so hard to secure funding and to get initial traction. Nevertheless, the founders managed to turn Airbnb into the famous and highly valued company that we know today. Hopefully, they will also manage to handle this current crisis. Thank you for watching our video. If you liked it, please don't forget to subscribe and push the bell button. We will keep uploading educating and interesting videos about the world's richest people and companies. Also, let us know in the comments about your experience with Airbnb. Especially in big and expensive cities, Airbnb can be a very neat and cheap alternative, right?